Hello. I'm going to talk about Trivially Relocatable. It's the thing on my badge. This is a little bit of a talk that I gave in Aspen, and I highly advise you all to go watch that talk, so you can all just get up and go right now. Let me talk about what this Trivially Relocatable thing is. Consider what happens when we resize a std vector, for example. This is my usual test case here. I have a vector. It's got a size and a capacity and a pointer to some heap allocated memory. And it's got these three T objects, A, B, C, and D. Let's say we try to push back something onto this vector. Well, we don't have any room in the vector, no capacity left, so we're going to allocate some more heap space. We're going to construct that E. We're going to construct the E first, doesn't matter why. In Aspen, I tell you why. And then we're going to have to get the objects, A, B, C, D, somehow from where they are into this new space of memory, right? We're going to have to somehow relocate them. I'm going to tell you about that word in a little bit. From where they are to this new place, and then we have to get rid of the originals. So basically, when I say relocate, what I mean is we're going to call the move constructor, and then we're going to call the destructor. And we're going to do that four times in a row. Now, of course, when vector does it, it actually calls move, 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 destroy, 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 destroy. Whereas it might actually be more cache efficient to call move, destroy, move, destroy, move, destroy, move, destroy. And by the way, I should say that in this case, I'm assuming that the move constructor is no except. If the move constructor is not no except, your program is bad and you should feel bad. This is the only case I care about. But of course, we can detect that already with typeface, right? Let's look at some code gen. We go to Godbolt, and here I've got GCC trunk and Clang trunk right next to each other on Godbolt, and you can play along at home with the URL in the upper corner there if you feel like it, and that way you won't be voting against me on the thing. It'll be great. So the red arrow, every slide needs, you know, arrows and circles and things. So the arrow is pointing at the code, the one-liner that we're compiling here. We have a vector of int star, and int star is actually trivially copyable. And we can detect that with type traits. We can detect that when we make copies or when we move and when we destroy, there's no side effects at all. It's just like a memcopy. And the compiler and the library together cooperate and are smart enough to turn that into a memcopy. We see here in the box the call memcopy, and on the other side, call q memcopy. And I have no idea why it's call memcopy in one case and call q memcopy in the other case. If anyone can explain how this possibly turns into different mnemonics. But anyway, the point is that it's calling memcopy in both cases, and this is very short, 48 lines of assembly to do the reserve on the one side, 43 lines on the other side. Now the problem comes when we look at a non-trivially copyable type, for example, shared putter event. Here I have a vector, a shared putter event, and I'm doing the exact same reserve. Now shared putter is also twice as big, but the important thing here is that it is non-trivial to copy and it's non-trivial to move. It's almost trivial to move. You just take the pointers from this side and put them on this side, but then you have to go back and you have to null out the others, right, to keep the reference count the same. And then you have to, that's non-trivial, so you have to do that in a loop, and there's a loop, and we look at what GCC is doing here, and it's calling some SP counted base thing inside its loop, and on the other side, I see pthreads is getting involved, and this is just crazy. And of course, it's much longer. So that's what happens when we relocate non-trivial types. But in theory, we could do it the same way, right? We could have a compiler, and it could be available on Godbolt today, and you could go to that link and see it for yourself if you theoretically you could do that, where we can actually tell that moving a shared putter from here to here and then destroying the original is actually a trivial operation. We can do it with a memcopy as long as we remember to drop the original on the floor, right? In principle, we can implement the relocation of A, B, C, D here, even when they're shared putters, by just memcopying everything and then just conveniently omitting to destroy the originals. We'll just drop them on the floor. So now we have not incremented the reference count, but we also have not decremented the reference count, so it remains where it was, and we're happy. And again, this operation of calling the move constructor and the destructor together in pairs is called relocation, says me. When a type has a relocation operation such as this, which is trivial, which is equivalent to memcopy, we call it trivially relocatable, says me. In Aspen, I gave some benchmark results for what this does to the performance characteristics of things like vector reserve. Here I have a benchmark that I wrote up using Google Benchmark. I highly recommend Google Benchmark. It's great. What is it doing here? It's timing the vector reserve right here. And we see that it's doing, I just noticed, this is notifying me of the vote count that I'm getting. This is highly distracting. keep it up, though. oh my God. All right. So at Aspen, I covered a sort of preliminary version of this. This was before it was available on Godbolt, and gave a whole bunch of different benchmarks. This is the benchmark for the vector reserve, and it does a single reserve, some number of reserves, I don't know. But the point is, it got 3 times faster. That's the take-home point, right? By getting to skip the move and destroy in a loop for unique putter and just using a memcopy instead, you get 3 times faster on vector reserve. Now, this is great if you're doing a whole lot of vector reserve all over the place, but most of us, you know, we do that once, right? That's the part that you put outside the loop. So I decided that if I got more time, which apparently I did, I guess, I was going to talk about more applications of it. But first, I guess I'd just tell you how you can play with it. So I had showed you that Godbolt way back here, right? Compiler Explorer. I'll give you like a minute to like... just look at that URL. Or if you look at the thing in the red box, right? It's a Clang experimental P1.4.4. So if you go there, you can play with the compiler extension that I've got. It adds one new attribute, which you can use very rarely. This is used in the library. Normal user code will not generally use this attribute. This is a way of opting in and saying for things like shared putter and unique putter, I promise that I am, in fact, trivially relocatable. And then there's this type trait, is trivially relocatable B, that you can use, that the library uses to detect when a class has this property. Much more often, it just happens automatically, the same way trivial copyability works, the same way trivial destructibility works. It's inherited in the obvious way when you follow the rule of zero. So as long as you don't provide a non-defaulted move constructor and non-defaulted destructor, as long as all of your members and base classes and so on are trivially relocatable, you yourself will be trivially relocatable. And you can play around with that on Compiler Explorer. So for more information, you can go there, or there. And my time is up.